Did you know that you can time block with Things and your calendar app by just dragging your tasks into the calendar and creating an event immediately?
Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and yes, we're going to show you how to time block using Things 3, and we're going to show you a bunch of other things that I think are helpful for using the app, whether you're a new user who just downloaded it for the first time and want to get set up, or if you've been using it for a long time and just want to make sure you're getting the most value out of it. I'm going to show you the things that I recommend setting up in the app to just get the best Things experience possible, and hopefully you'll find it useful. So let's jump back into the screen share. Okay, so this is a fresh install of Things, and we're just going to get started. The first thing I recommend everybody do is go into the settings, go to Things Cloud, and turn on Things Cloud. Basically, Things does not sync over iCloud or anything, so if you want your tasks to sync between your devices, or if you want to have an online backup in case you lose your Mac or iPhone or whatever device you're using, turn on Things Cloud. It's totally free. You can create an account or log in if you've already done that, and it will automatically sync. The sync is very quick. I'm not going to do it on video here because I'm kind of working in a sandbox, but Things Cloud is really, really good, and again, totally free. So if you're using the app and you want it to sync between your devices or have an online backup, turn on Things Cloud. The second thing I think you'll find really useful is if you go to Reminders, they have the option to automatically, semi-automatically import your tasks from the Reminders app. So if you ever need to add tasks with Siri or something and you forget to say in Things or like whatever, there's situations where you can really only easily save a reminder to Things or to Reminders. And so this, basically, you'll turn this on. The first time you do it, it's going to ask you for permission to access your reminders, and it's going to show you a list of all of your reminder lists. And I have one just called Reminders. It's kind of the default one. And let me kind of bring that up so you can see. If I go into Reminders, I have three tasks in here, all today, actually, 2 p.m., 3 p.m., 5 p.m., that I just have created earlier. So we're going to leave this open and just kind of off here to the side so you can see it in real time. Okay, I've got this set up. Let's get out of here. And now, when I go to my inbox the next time, it's going to see, oh, here are some tasks from Reminders, and they have the names, the times. If you have location-based ones, those won't come in because Things can't support that. But this will make it so that basically when you go to your inbox, if there are any uncompleted reminders in whatever list you gave it access to, you can go ahead and import them. And you can click next to in individual one. So let's say take out the trash. I want to import. It's going to tell you the first time that it's going to basically delete the reminder from Reminders so you don't get double alerted. So it imports, take out the trash is in your today thing. If I click into it, it's at 5 p.m. And then I can just also do import all. You can see it's deleted those from Reminders. They've brought them into Things, and each one of these is going to be at the time that they were supposed to be. So that's great. Now we have a couple tasks in our today view. So let's get to Reminders out of here. So I wanted to jump in here real quick and just say that this video is not sponsored by anybody, but I did want to shout out Relay FM's annual fundraiser they do for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, which does incredible work. If you don't know, the big thing that they kind of do is treat kids with cancer, and they do research to try to make it so that cancer doesn't kill any kids in the future, which would be an incredible reality to live in. But they do all of this without ever charging the families of these kids anything. It's a really, really remarkable thing. And so I wanted to shout it out today. There is a link in the description if you want to donate through my link. That's awesome. It's kind of linked to Relay FM's fundraiser. It all goes to the same place. I would love to see if we can earn some money for that campaign, get St. Jude a little bit more money so they can keep doing the good work they're doing. Again, donation down below. If you can give anything, obviously not everybody can, but if you can, I think it's a really good cause. The next thing I want to show you is time blocking. And so if we bring up the calendar, and I've got kind of a blank calendar here, let's say I'm looking at my day, right? So this is my day. Let me scale this down. So I'm looking at my calendar, I'm looking at Things, and I'm like, okay, these are the things I need to do today. When am I going to do this? I want to make sure I need to walk the dog at 3 p.m. There's a reason why it's important. So what I want to do is make sure I have an event for that. So walk the dog, I'm going to drag this to 3 p.m. There we go, and now I have an event. And so that's it. That's great. I can go ahead and delete this, and then we'll say it's a 30-minute thing, right? So just change that. Boom, I think it defaults to an hour, but we could drag these in. There's that one. We're going to say that's like a 15-minute thing. Take out the trash. That'll be after work. And again, that's just a tiny little thing. And if these are larger tasks, these are more work-oriented tasks. These are all kind of like personal things. But you can drag them in here, and now they're calendar events on whatever calendar. I'm doing this in the Calendars app for just Apple's Calendars app, but it works in Fantastical as well. I haven't tested other apps, but yeah, you can drag these out and bring them in, and it works pretty darn nice. So I love that feature. Okay, so now I've added a couple more tasks, and you can start to see I'm running into some organization issues, right? Like, these are different things. Some are at work, some are home things. This is like I need to do on my computer. It would be nice to organize these a little bit. And so we can do that with areas. So down here in the bottom left, and again, on the iPhone, iPad, you can do this anywhere. We have options for new project or new area. And the very short version is projects are things where they have a beginning and end, and you start a project and you'll eventually end the project and mark the project as complete. Whereas areas are more parts of your life. So they're things that aren't really complete. They're just categories that a task could be in. So we're going to create an area. And so our first area we're going to call home. And what I would recommend is using emoji. So I like putting emoji at the start of this. So we have an area called home. Let's go create another area. We're going to call this one office. So let's do office. Building, here it is. So this one's going to be called work. And we'll do one more area called, we'll do laptop, and this is going to be called computer. Now, I have a few other areas, but this is a good kind of starting point. And I'm going to put computer at the bottom. I'm going to keep work at the top because I'm at work at the start of the day pretty much. And actually, I'm going to do one more list. So this is my kind of secret one. This is going to be sun and morning. Cool. So these are the four that I think are essential, and then you may have some more. But these are general areas. So things I want to do in the morning, things I want to do at work, things I want to do at home, and things I want to do on a computer. And so this helps me organize things. So now, because things is excellent, you can just drag things around. So email my boss. That's clearly a work task. Call the doctor. That's a home task. Check the project status. That's a work thing. Install an OS update. That's on the computer. Walk the dog. We'll say that's going to be a home thing, and take out the trash is a home thing as well. So now I have these assigned to different areas. I can click into an area and see the tasks that are assigned to that. Cool. But this today view, which is what you spend most of your time in, at least most people will spend most of their time in the app, is still kind of unsorted. So that brings us to our next tip, which is to go into the settings and go to general. I'm going to move this over and then group to-dos in the today list by project or area. This is super, super helpful. So when I do this, it's going to sort them. And this is finally looking like what I'm actually working with day to day in things. Here's my work stuff. So throughout the workday, I can see those right at the top. And then there's the home stuff, and then there's computer stuff, right? And these will follow the order that you have them in the sidebar. So if you personally want home to be at the top, you can move it. That's fine. So you can arrange these however you want. It's really, really nice. If I create a new project called, let's do new launch, right? So this is a product launch. It's at work. I can drag it under the work area. And then if I do item one, item two, item three, and then let's say these two are due today. And again, kind of dragging things around is really great. I'm going to set this as due tomorrow. If I go to my today view, new launch is below work, but above home. And again, you can kind of move them around, whatever works for you. But you can start marking things off. You can see some progress showing here. Pretty nice stuff. So that's how I would recommend setting up some areas. You may have other things. I have other areas. I have one area called YouTube, which is for these videos. I have another one for freelance work and that sort of stuff. But these, I think, are a really cool thing. And the morning one, I didn't mention the morning one. So things has a way to, if you click this calendar here, you can have them do on the day. You can set a reminder time, or you can say this evening. And the idea of this evening, and let's do like call the doctor this evening as well. Let's get rid of that reminder. Cool. And the idea is that you put tasks here that you just want to kind of do maybe after work, after you're kind of relaxing. These are things you can do at the end of the day. I like having some things that I do before the day starts, right? And so I, like while I'm just waking up, maybe I'm watching some YouTube videos, eating my breakfast, there's some little tasks that I can get done. And so to do that, I have this morning area. So walk the dog, maybe that makes sense to do in the morning. I can pop it up here, and then I have morning, all the stuff during the day, and then this evening. So I've asked the company who makes the app if they could add a this morning area, kind of like their this evening. They said they're not really interested in it, but for me, having this area called morning works really, really nicely and kind of makes it feel like it is exactly what this is, just for earlier in the day. So those are the areas that I recommend setting up, and I think that'll get you going really nicely in Things. Another thing I would say is you should really get comfortable with keyboard shortcuts. So there's a lot of keyboard shortcuts. I've shown you kind of how you can do everything with dragging and dropping things around the app with your mouse or your finger. Works on iPad and iOS. But all this stuff is possible with keyboard shortcuts as well. I can just kind of arrow up and down to access my tasks. I can hit Command K to mark the selected task as complete. So that's really nice. You can hit Enter on any of them to expand. You can tab through the different things on your list. You can escape to collapse it. What else? Let's say walk the dog is just kind of not in a category. One of the things that I found frustrating is that I had to like pick up my mouse and move it somewhere. There's actually a keyboard shortcut for that. It's Command Shift M, and you can decide what project you want that to go under. So let's say this goes into Home. So walk the dog is in Home, and let's say I want to change the time, right? I can hit Command S. I don't know why it's Command S. Some of these are kind of strange shortcuts, but let's say this is at 6 p.m. and you can just use natural language and that works. Or if this is like tomorrow, 5 p.m., you can do that. So natural language works for the date selection, and then I can arrow through here as well and just kind of pick the thing that works for me. So keyboard shortcuts are really awesome. Is there another one? There probably are. If I go into the app settings and go into Quick Entry, there's a global keyboard shortcut for Quick Entry, which by default is Control Space, and you can enable Quick Entry for autofill, which basically will pull what you're working on from an email app, from a website. So if you're in your browser, you can hit the shortcut. It'll save automatically the URL that you're on. I think I went over that in a different video, but I'll just show you in general. We've got things off the board. We're just on the desktop. This could be any app. And I hit Control Space. It brings up this new picker. And I can say, new task. Cool. And I can tab through the note. I can say it's due today. And then I can keep tabbing through. And we'll say this is a computer thing. Save it. There we go. And then, of course, when I bring up Things, new task is right here under the computer category as I wanted it to be. So get comfortable with some of the keyboard shortcuts. On iOS, you can just hold down the command key and see them all pop up. You'll kind of learn them over time. Like I said, some of them aren't totally standard. You can hit like command N to do a new task in whatever view you're looking at, hit escape to cancel, that sort of stuff. So some of it's intuitive, some of it's a little weird. Like I said, the command K is a slightly odd one for marking a task complete, but it is what it is. And once you get used to them, they're really, really helpful. So whether you're like using your keyboard or a mouse to do whatever you want, basically all of it's possible with Things. And it's one of the things I really like about the app. Okay. And finally, we have an interesting one. So one of the big complaints that people have with Things is that you can set up recurring reminders, but those recurring reminders are a little weird. It's weird to set them up in the first place, and you can't mark them as complete early. I'm going to show you how to set them up and then how to mark them complete early, but the early one's kind of a weird one. So we're going to create a recurring reminder that a lot of people probably have, and we'll do pay the rent. Rent doesn't need to be capitalized. Cool. So pay the rent is the task, and let's go ahead and hit these three dots and do repeat. So this needs to be done every month, and it's going to be every single month, and let's say it's on the fifth day of the month. And the first one will be September 5th, because that's the next time we have a fifth of the month as I'm recording this. So when I go ahead and create this, we're going to see it in upcoming and pay the rent. So it's not in my today view. That makes sense. And let's actually clear out, all these actually, just so we don't muddy the waters. So nothing's in my today view, and I have, don't need that either. I have pay the rent on the 5th, but I can't mark this as complete, right? There's no checkbox next to it. There's no way to do this early. This is what drives people crazy. You can improve this a little bit though. So if we go into it and change this, So we can leave it all the same, but you want to add a deadline. So add deadlines and start 0 days earlier. So let's say I can pay this up to a week ahead of time. So we're going to say 7 days earlier. So it's still due on the fifth day of every month, but 7 days ahead of that, it's going to start showing this in the today view. And I think I actually screwed this up. Did I? No. No, that's good. So I've changed it. And now it is due on, why is it the 28th? Oh boy, this is strange. No, I see what's going on. So, so again, this is why it's a little strange thing. It's why it's at the end of the video. So pay the rent. It's due in 5 days. The deadline is the fifth, but it is in my today view and I can mark it off early. Now I can also change the due date. I can move this task to tomorrow and it's still going to have 5 days left. I can move it to the fourth and it's still going to have the Tuesday deadline, but I can mark it complete up to 7 days ahead of time. It's annoying, and I can't do the next one right now because I need more time to pass. It's definitely annoying that this is how it works, but if there is a situation where, like, pay the rent, you can pay it every single month. Let's start this on the 9th again, and let's say there is, like, there's, like, a window where you can start doing it. You can go ahead and do that, and now I'm kind of in, like, a weird state. I've kind of screwed it up a little bit, so we're going to delete that, but if you need to create a recurring reminder that you can mark off early, deadlines kind of make it possible, but it's strange. So I just wanted to share that. It's a slight workaround, but it really would be great if things allowed you to just mark things done ahead of time. Hopefully that's coming in an update one day. It's like one of the things I always hear people talk about, but yeah, kind of frustrating. But that is it for me today. Those are some tips for using Things 3. Again, I think it's a really great app. I'll link to the like six other videos I've made about the app below, kind of showing you more my actual work, my setup for the app. It's basically the same. It's really a consistent, really very good app in my opinion. So yeah, take a look, let me know what you think, and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.